Hey guys, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and today we are going to start a new playlist. So this is related to the SQL Server real-time scenarios. So here the first scenario that we are going to discuss, like how we can insert and delete in the same query without using the merge statement. So basically, let's assume inside the store procedure we are having a table and we want to delete the data on that table, and at the same time we want to insert the data into the error log table. So like how we can do that? So in a single query we just want to delete that, and on that query we also want to insert the data into error log table. Or we could say like how we can use the magic tables outside the triggers. So here we will see about these. So go to on the SQL Server Management Studio and we'll see in the practical. So here, as you can see, we are having the first table, that is user temp table, and second, that is error log table. So first we just want to create these two tables, so we can directly execute the create statement, and after that we want to insert the data on the table, so we can directly insert the data into the user temp table. Now we can check the data. So here we could see we are having 5 rows. So what is our requirement? Our requirement is we want to delete the data where the organization name is not equals to SS Unitech, that we could see for ID 3, 4 and 5. So we want to delete that data in this table, and at the same time we want to insert that data into error log table. So this could be used inside the store procedures where we might need to delete some data on the user table or any another table, and at the same time we want to insert the data into error log tables. So here we can directly write the delete statement. So delete, then from, and after that we could see this user temp. So we can directly copy this and paste it here, and let me call this as user temp. So that is UT. So we want to delete the data from this UT table. That looks good, but we want to insert the data into the error log table. So for that we have to use the output keyword after this UT and before that from. Then we could directly use the deleted, that is the magic table. Then we could use the dot ID, we can put comma, then we could use the deleted dot the second, that is name, then put comma, then deleted dot organization name. So we are having the first column, that is ID, second name, and third is the organization name. The last one, that is the error description. So we could say like the organization is not valid, and we want to insert that inside the error log table. So we can directly use this statement. So this is very straightforward. Like we just want to delete the data from this user temp table, and here we could also use the where organization name is not equals to SS Unitech. So we want to delete only that data. So this is a very straightforward query, like delete from this UT table, that is user temp, where organization name is not equals to SS Unitech. In between UT and from we have to use the output keyword, and after that we could use the magic tables. So here like we are going to delete the data. So ID from the deleted table, then name, then organization name, and last one the description of the error. So now we just want to execute this delete statement. So once we execute, then we could see 3 rows affected. Now I just wanna write the select asterisk from user temp table. So data should be deleted from this table and should be inserted into the error log table. Now let me execute these two tables and we'll check the output. So as we could see here in the first table, the ID 3, 4 and 5 has been deleted, and that is inserted inside the error log table. And here error description is saying organization is not valid. So that we could use inside the store procedure in the real time. So here like we could also specify multiple deletes with the description of the error. So this we could use, and here we could also see like how we can use the magic tables outside the triggers, because here we don't have the trigger, we just want to delete the data. So I hope guys you have understand how we can insert and delete in the same query without using the merge statement. We'll see in the next video with one more real-time scenario. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much. See you in the next video.